Hello everyone, today we'll discuss about the gain storage method and storage structure that is under the course AE4202 Agri Processing Engineering 2 Unit 3. So let's get started. Before discussing about the gain storage structure, some background information we will discuss. And food gain production increase year by year in order to fulfill the demand of increasing population. In India, annual production was 275.68 million ton in 2016-17. Okay, however, there is a marginal increase in capacity of structures of gain storage. This resulted losses both in quality and quantity of harvested grain. Okay. It is reported that on an average a loss of 9.33% per annum. Okay, so this is a big issue. Quality percentage of gain loss due to lack of proper gain storage. Okay, it is observed that farmer kept 60% of total gain produce and remaining 40% quantity as marketable surplus. Marketable surplus means the portion of a harvest that a farmer can sell on the market to earn profit. Okay. Main factor and responsible for losses in quality and quantity of gain. These are, we all know that, insect, rodent, and dampness. Okay, these three are mainly responsible for grain losses. Okay, come to the next slide. Existing storage methods and there are many existing storage methods. These are number one. Stored in bag in a house level, that is generally used by farmer. Okay, number two, stored in bag on platform or covering them by polythene, that is cap means cover and plinth. Okay. And after that, store in bag either in godown and bukhari type structure. Okay. Number four, store in indigenous storage structure and traditional device such as basket, theka, earthen pots, etc. Okay. Basic requirement to safeguard of good of food gains. These are cleaning, drying, and keeping them in airtight containers. So these three are main safeguard of food gain. Okay. Come to the next slide. Requirement of food storage structure. And for quality food storage structure, following the following the measure are generally carried out. Protection from harmful biological agents like insects, rats, birds, etc. Number two, protection from excessive humidity, temperature, and moisture. Number three, provision for making the store airtight and aeration. Number four, proper facility for filling and emptying. Number five, facility for proper cleaning. Number six, facility of easy handling. Number seven, facility for easy inspection of grains. Number eight, protection of grain from fire, storm, rain and thief. Number nine, cheap and economical. Okay, these are the requirement of good storage structures. Okay, come to the next slide. Traditional grain storage structure and their capacity. Number one, mud kothi. It is capacity around 2 to 5 quintal. It is locally made of soil. Number two, gunny bags. Its capacity around 1 quintal. Commercially available in the market. Number three, underground pits. And the storage structure that is constructed in underground. Okay, and it is capacity around 50 to 100 quintal. Dark plaster and protected from rain water. It dark plaster in order to protect it from the rain water. Okay, and number four, bamboo basket. Its capacity around 0.222 made at village level. Okay, grain is stored either in bag or bulk storage in warehouse. Okay, sometimes combined system of bag cum bulk storage is also available. Size of bags used for grain storage is about 93 kg. These bags are made of jute fibers and commonly known as gunny bags. Okay, come to the next slide. Designing a modern grain storage structure. In order to design a modern grain storage structure, we have to remind the following concept. Orientation of structure, minimum aeration. Whenever design a grain storage structure, it should be kept in mind that aeration should be minimum. And after that, checking for the high water table in areas where underground pits are to be located. After that, permit aeration and fumigation when required. Protect from rodent parts, insect, mites, etc. Facilities proper cleaning permit easy inspection. Protect the grain from weather, fire and thief. Economical on unit storage cost basis. Provision for future expansions. Okay, these are requirement for proper designing of grain storage structure. Come to the next slide. Measure of good storage. Measure of good storage proper disposal of rainwater, repair of cracks, crevices. Crevices means narrow cracks and corners where insects can hide. Fumigation of storage space and surrounding. Protection from fire, forage. Protection from fire, field forage and rodent attacks. Use of good quality gunny bags. Grain moisture should be maintained for safe storage. Okay. Come to the next slide. The comparison between silo and good storage and godown storage. Okay, in construction point of view, silo are generally bolted MS and GIC, that means MS means mill steel and GIC means galvanized iron corrugated. And in case of godown, bricks, concrete, asbestos roof, RCC floor generally used for construction purpose. Rensselaer systems. Rensselaer means necessary for support bucket hole. Necessary for support, and it is cleaning, drying, aeration, conveying, temperature detection are provided. And in case of godown, there is no provision. And handling, mechanical, and in case of silo, and in case of godown, it is generally done by manually. And losses due to damage, humidity, part, pest, and rodent can be controlled both case. And quality storage in case of silo is good. In case of godown, it is deteriorate. Number six, fumigation not required in case of silo. In case of godown, it is essential. And number seven, pesticide and fungi, it is also not required for silo, but it is essential for godown. So overall comparison, we can see that silo always better than the godown storage. Okay, now to the next slide. Again, grain losses during transmit, maximum permissible losses in transit is around 0.1% for distance up to 1000 kilometers, and 0.15% for distance up to 2000 kilometers, and 0.2% for a distance over 2000 kilometers. Okay, insects and rats are the greatest enemy of a human being so far as the loss of food gain are concerned. We all know that the following oil tested method will be prevented the infestation of gain by insect. Hygienic method of insect and pest control, hermetic technology of insect and pest control, aeration or dehydration technology, heat treatment method, use of chemical most popular method generally used. Okay, fumigation done in a closed container or closed space for a defined period. It is process of creating lethal environment with help of toxic gas. Okay, commonly used fumigants are aluminium phosphate, ethyl dibromide. Okay, come to the next slide. Grain pressure theory. Hydrostatic formula. It is calculate the lateral pressure, that is P1, P sub is 1 equal to W into H. Okay, where P sub is 1 is lateral pressure exerted by gain on pin 1, W is density of gain, and H depth of gain from top of pin surface. Some of the remarks of this method had serious deficiency and many structure bulkhead means collapse under vertical load arising from the friction of the grain on the walls. Okay. Next, number B is Rankine formula. Above formula was modified to introduce above formula means that hydrostatic formula are modified in this Rankine formula by the factor K, that is known Rankine earth pressure coefficient. Okay, in this case P1 equal to KW into H. Okay, where K equal to 1 minus sin pi by 1 plus sin pi, that is called Rankine coefficient. Pi is the angle of internal friction of K. This formula reduced the magnitude of lateral pressure. The whole height of the gain was assumed to be transferred to bottom of plane. Okay, come to the next slide. Jason formula. Jason proposed that the formula for deep bin by taking account friction between the gain and bin, that is P1 equal to W into R by mu, and 1 minus exponential function under bracket minus K mu S by R. Okay, P where P1 lateral pressure adjusted by gain on bin wall, W is density of gain, R hydraulic radius, S equal to depth of gain from the top of bin, and mu seems to coefficient of friction of gain on the wall, that is mu equal to 10 pi, and K equal to 1 minus sine pi 1 by 1 plus sine pi, that is Rankine coefficient. Thank you for listening to me.